doing well and getting hopefully getting a little bit more of normalcy back as things are starting to open up a little bit. So, and hopefully everybody's continuing to be healthy during this time. This week we're going to look at the CMHC, also known as the Canadian Mortgage and Housing Corporation's report that just came out this past week. Their report indicated that the average home prices throughout Canada are going to decrease anywhere from 9 to 18% in the next 12 months. I mean, we don't know for sure what's going to happen, and we don't know what the future has in store for Kelowna or for BC in general. Currently, right now, all we know is where we're at, and inventory right now for the single family home market is relatively low. Everybody being quarantined at home is really making the single family homes quite appealing, and we're starting to see a lot, still fairly strong demand on that. With that being said, the condo inventory is seeing different signs of it. We're starting to see it creep up a little bit. There's a little bit less demand out there currently. That's also partly as well because of it. A lot of the complexes as well are 55 plus, which obviously are higher risk, and people are less likely purchasing in those age plus brackets currently. And we'll probably start to see a little bit more demand happen as things continue to open up and get some. Canada-wide, we saw about 700,000 people utilize the mortgage deferral payments. Whether or not people needed it or not, or if they just utilized it just because they weren't sure of what was going to happen, you know, I mean, that will remain to be seen. However, come September 1st, if people did utilize it and they really did need it, we're going to start seeing those mortgage deferrals. People are going to have to start paying, and it's going to create a cash flow issue. Again, as well, we're going to start seeing the CERB, the benefits that Canada is paying people, that is going to expire after 16 weeks. So coming up in 3 months, after 3 months in June here, we're going to start seeing people that have utilized that start to maybe potentially have some a little bit more cash flow issues. I mean, with that information, really what I've been asked quite a bit lately is, do I fix up my home and add value so I can get out the amount of money I want out of it, or do I just sell it as is? I mean, the answer to that is it depends, and it usually will depend on a number of things, and that usually was my answer, and it continues to be my answer. However, it's important in this market to keep in mind of the amount of timing. You know, with all these things, we don't know what's going to happen late summer, early fall, with the motivation as people go in. What I would caution you is timing, and focus on the amount of timing instead of just value what you're getting out of it. It's also the timing of it, and if you're willing to risk it and put all that money in, and then you can't get the money out in 2 months from now, then that's when you would have to look and see, okay, are we okay living in the home with the renovation and willing to buy time till we can get the money out of it? Or would we prefer just to sell now, maybe take a little bit lower price, but just know that what we can get out of the value out of it, and maybe we can buy at a price that's relative, or we can get into a market and spend that money that we had spent on the renovation and spend it on the new place and make it a renovation that you would like. CMHC is calling for a price decline nationally. However, you know, Kelowna could buck that trend, and the rest of BC could also buck the trend. We don't know. It's all specific in the individual markets and everything. So if you are looking to renovate and you may or may not sell, you're on the fence a little bit, and but you do want to do a renovation, you know, maybe make it tailor to something that you might want to live in if you're dead set on it. But if you're focused on just selling and you know you're going to be want to move somewhere else, now might be the best time to put your house on the market and just sell it as is and save that cash flow for your new place there. Typically, when you buy and sell in the same market, providing you are purchasing in the same marketplace, that you know it's relatively balanced out, and you'll end up paying the same, roughly around the same there. So that's something to keep in mind there. Thanks for watching, everybody. Reach out if you do have any questions. I'd be more than happy to help you out there. And please like and subscribe to the video if you want to continue to see what's coming out there. Take care and have a great week.